I've come to the end of 70 years of preaching. I can't imagine how many people I've bored. you're almost the last. I should be there next week with their friends at where am I going?
Ebenezer
Colville. So that's my final preach. But it's wonderful to be able to share God's word together, isn't it? Really amazing what we can share together. So I was very grateful to. Sorry about that. I was very grateful to Simon for inviting me to come once again. So, what is it like to walk with Jesus? What is it like to walk with Jesus? Because this is the story that Sonia read to us. I think it's a very fascinating insight into one of those very significant Easter accounts. We actually have the advantage of four different accounts from the pens of the four disciples. Don't often get that. Four different accounts, but they all beautifully blend together. So Matthew, who spent 20 verses, and he finished with the words that Jesus spoke, "Go! Go!" And that's your commission, isn't it? That's our commission as believers, to go, to share the love of God. Mark, same, 20 verses. He finished with, "Go into it, all the world, and preach the gospel." Come on, Rosalie, that's your mission call this morning. Now Luke, well, he loved to tell the story. So he did it with 53 verses. including one of my most favourite Bible stories, which is the walk to Emmaus. Do you remember that story? That's a beautiful story, isn't it? The walk to Emmaus. And John followed up with 48 verses, including the reading that we've shared together. So this is how the Holy Spirit directed these four men to record this. Well, it's the greatest story in the world's history, isn't it? Someone say yes.
Yes.
Because it is an amazing account of what God has done. So many insights, so many facets, so many personal experiences. Do please remember, when you read this or you hear it read, these are personal remembrances of people who actually walked with Jesus. Amazing. But that Lord is still alive in our lives today. We've seen that this morning as we prayed and we worship. I wonder what your favourite account in Scripture is. I think I have to say that my favourite story is the walk to Emmaus. Something very special about that. And what a privilege that we have to have that same experience in our Christian lives, to walk, as it were. It's worth reminding ourselves, isn't it, that this is an historical account. This is not just a story. It's an historical account of an actual event. I was very sad some years ago when I heard that one of the Church of England high up talked about the resurrection as a juggling trick with bones. Would you believe that? Juggling trick with bones. How But here is something. There were seven eyewitnesses to this thing that we read this morning. So the scene moves away from Jerusalem, away from the upper room where they met Jesus for their first resurrection occurrences and so on. It all had this kind of feeling, men saying to each one another, well, what's next? We've met the risen Lord, but what's next? Where do we go from here? Perhaps I need to say to somebody this morning that where the future is uncertain for you, and the path is not clear, go back to your roots. Go back to that time when you first fell in love with Jesus. And move again. That's what they did. They picked up their previous lives. The old-fashioned trick of fishing at night. Here are professional fishermen. And you know how much they caught. Nothing. Seven professionals and they didn't even catch a sprat. And you know how the story, which has been read to you, unfolding. What a blow to their pride. What a challenge to their self-sufficiency. But we shouldn't point the finger, should we? Because we're very good at that, you know. We're very good at relying on our own self-sufficiency. I can do it. I can make it. I'm in charge of my life. I can achieve what I want to achieve. And it was then that they discovered that there was someone who had more knowledge than they had. More competent than even they were. Exchange of a few words with an unknown, unrecognized stranger, with the words, throw your nets on the right side of the boat. Tiredness and frustration tempted them, I think, just to say, oh, no, okay, we'll try it. They became unable. Can I just pause there for a moment? Unable. Are there things that you're unable to do? You feel not qualified, not experienced enough? Sounds very good. Saying, you're no good, really. You can't come. Forget it. Do your own thing. The words of advice came. Throw your nets on the right side. Well, you know the story. Jesus. Nothing better than that, surely. Spend breakfast with Jesus. But what happened was a very gentle but piercing investigation of where Peter really stood with Jesus. So this is what happened. Here is Jesus walking along the beach with Peter. Peter, do you love me? Yes. steps. Peter, you do love me, don't you? Yes, Lord. I really do love you. Mm-hmm. Peter, come on. Let's be honest. Do you really love me? Scripture says Peter was grieved when Jesus asked him the third time. But you and I know what he was doing. He was the spiritual surgeon that was actually dealing with the three times that Peter had denied knowing the Lord around the fire. Remember the story, don't you? That had to be dealt with. That was the thing that was eating at Peter's heart all those days after the crucifixion. Peter, do you really, really love me? Yes, Lord. Lord, you know everything. And so he survived it, I suppose. A story we know well. A gentle but effective spiritual surgery that Jesus did with a torn heart to mend. Dear Peter, Harry wriggled. And you and I do that at times, do we not? And God challenges us to take a further step with him. We say, well, yeah, perhaps tomorrow, Lord. Perhaps next week. Life's too complicated at the moment for me. I wonder. Is there someone here this morning that needs to hear Jesus say to them, do you really love me? Are you prepared to go all the way with me? Is it just possible that from now on you really will be a disciple, a follower, a lover of Jesus? I ask the question, but it's not me really, it's Jesus. A moment of quiet. Lord, we've been there in our imagination this morning. We've walked the beach. There's been this gentle spiritual surgery into our hearts afresh. Do we really, really love this amazing Saviour of ours? Lord, help us to leave this morning reinforced in our faith, re-encouraged in our trust, and more importantly,